The slope of a line measures how quickly a line rises or falls. In other words, it measures the steepness of the line. What we want is, given a line, let's say like this one, we'd like to be able to find a numerical value to attach to this line. Usually we use the letter M, and this number here is gonna represent how steep that line is. So like this line would have a particular slope. And then if you compare that to, let's say, this line's slope, the second line I just drew, its slope would be a little larger because it's a little steeper. The third line would be even a little larger, its slope would. The fourth line would have an even larger slope. And so we want to associate numerical values to exactly how steep this line is. Now, how do we do that? We'll talk about that in just a minute. But anyway, that's what we're trying to do. Now let's talk about a few properties we want out of our slope whenever we're defining it. One thing I want, if a line is tilted upwards, I want that to be indicated by a positive slope. And if it's tilted downwards, I want it indicated by a negative slope. And if it's completely flat, I'd like that it would be equal to zero. All right, now when I say goes up or goes down, what I mean is as you go from left to right, because somebody could argue, you know, for this example, this is tilted upwards if you're facing left. Well, that's not what I'm talking about, though. When I say increasing or decreasing or going up or going down, I always mean as you go from left to right. So for example, if there was a little man and he was walking from left to right, in the first example he's walking uphill, and in the second example, he's walking downhill. So this will be a positive slope. This will be a negative slope. And if our little man is on flat ground, the slope will be zero. That's what I want. That's what I'm after. So how do we do this? How do we attach a numerical value to all these different types of lines? Well, before we get into that, let me actually mention one last thing, and this will help us understand how we find the slope of a line. Let's talk first about how to find the slope between just two points, then we'll talk about lines. Given two points like this, the way we indicate the steepness between these two points is a ratio of how high it goes up from one point to another compared to how much it goes over from one point to another. We call this vertical change the rise between the two points, and we call the horizontal difference between the two points the run. Run is horizontal, rise is vertical. So your formula for slope would look something like this. M indicates slope, as I mentioned earlier, is equal to the rise between these two points compared to the run between these two points. And we need a ratio of both of those numbers. Now, I can actually give you a more specific formula than that. Let's think about it for a minute. If this guy has a height of y2, and this point here has a height of y1, then what is the rise from one point to another? Well, it would be y2 minus y1. So that'll be your numerator exactly, y2 minus y1. Divided by, and let's do the same thing for the run. What's the horizontal distance between these two points? Well, here is x2 and here is x1. So the run would be x2 minus x1. So this right here is an extremely important formula. I would strongly encourage you to commit this formula to memory. The slope between two points is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. A lot of students mess up the order of those, so be careful you don't say x2 minus x1 over y2 minus y1. Make sure to do rise over run and not run over rise. That doesn't make any sense. All right, now if you're talking about the steepness of a line though, or steepness between two points, you might ask yourself, well, Devin, why don't we just need the rise? Isn't that sufficient to indicate the steepness of a line? Why do we need to talk about run? Well, let me give you kind of a cheesy analogy, but I think it'll work. I think it'll do the trick. Let's say there was a flat piece of ground, and let's say there's a friend of ours who comes to us and tells us that they just hiked up a really large hill that was 200 feet tall. And so they tell us this, and then we're trying to think about whether this was a steep hill or not. 200 feet, that's pretty tall. But let's think about this for a minute. If this hill did go up 200 feet, in fact, but over a span of only 10 feet horizontally, yes, that is an extremely steep hill. He would really have to work to get up that hill because it would be almost vertically, because he not only went up 200 feet, but he did it over such a short horizontal distance. But on the other hand, if he went up 200 feet, but he did it over the span of 500 feet, well, then that's not that impressive. That's a very flat hill. And so you realize we need not only the rise, but we need the rise in comparison to what the run is. And so that's why we have to have rise over run as the slope between two points. Now you hear me say all that, and you say, well, Devin, I don't really care what the slope is between two points. I thought we were talking about the slope of a line. Well, let me make that connection for you. The slope between any two points on a line is actually going to be equal to what we're going to call the slope of that line. Let me just draw you an example, because I know that sentence sounds a little confusing. Let's say you're going from here to here, and I'm just going to make up some numbers here. Let's say you go up a total of 2 units while you go horizontally over 3 units. So the M, the slope between those two points, would be 2/3, rise over run. But think about it, since this is a straight line, what if you went from this point to a point farther on the line? Well, then you know what? You might go up a total of 4 units while you run 6 units. So maybe this is 4 and this whole distance is 6. Well, check this out. 4/6 is equivalent to 2/3. It's the same ratio. And so hopefully that makes sense, that you can take any 2 points on the line, and that ratio will be the same rise to run between any 2 points. Yes, the rise might be different between 2 points, and the run might be different, but the ratio will not be different. Going up 2 feet compared to a run of 3 feet would be like going up vertically 4 feet while horizontally going over 6 feet. Or, and you could keep this going. You could say 6 feet to 9 feet, or 8 feet to 12 feet. It doesn't matter. The ratio will stay 2/3. And so that's how we get the slope of a line. You can take any 2 points, use your slope formula that you learned on the previous page, y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, and that will give you the slope of the entire line. Now, in the next video, we're actually going to unpack a little bit more, and we'll do some examples where we actually find the slope between multiple points.